This is so fascinating. I can't wait to talk to you about it. As you might recall, in my non-spoiler review for Spider-Man Far From Home, I said that Kevin Feige not only seems to be getting much more comfortable telling these stories, but as a result, bolder as well. And the end credit scene in Spider-Man Far From Home reveals, it seems to, and the genius of it, as we're about to discuss. It's just, I had no idea how genius it was until I did this breakdown. He's going to be doing something so interesting with Phase 4 and fundamentally changing some of the stories in the comics more so than he's ever done before, more aggressively, but I think in a really interesting and intelligent way that I think hopefully everyone's going to go along with. All right, so speaking of spoilers, I had this end credit scene spoiled for me with a source telling me prior to my press screening that it revealed that Nick Fury was a Skrull. And my reaction was, before having actually seen the scene, secret invasion, here we come, which is something I've been rooting for and pushing quite hard ever since we heard the Skrulls were coming to the MCU. Because again, why else introduce them? Well, Kevin Feige has a why else. Although I think secret invasion is still gonna kind of be mixed in here. You'll see. So it turns out, that Kevin Feige is actually going to continue with the very different direction that he has with the Skrulls and Captain Marvel, that they're good guys, right? Because it's revealed in this end credit scene in Spider-Man Far From Home that both Nick Fury and Maria Hill are Skrulls, but not just any Skrulls, Skrulls we've met before, Talos and his wife Soren. Now, it's been 30 years since Captain Marvel, which took place in 1995, and remember, they had the blip, they're calling it the blip in the MCU, they had the time jump 5 years ahead, so it's been 30 years, but I guess because they're Skrulls, they still look the same. They can, of course, choose not to to age their appearance because they're in charge of their appearance. But here's where things get nuts, because it's also revealed that they haven't taken Nick Fury and Maria Hill's place, like was the case in Secret Invasion. It was an invasion, but instead Fury has intentionally put them on Earth to cover for him and Hill. He wants them to take their place. So talk about cleverly taking life model decoys to the next level. In your face, Jeff Loeb! Now, as some of you laugh, others, I'm sure, are scratching their heads. So if you aren't aware of what life model decoys are, or LMDs, in the comics, S.H.I.E.L.D. is famous for using them, especially Fury, to replace himself. But of course, as some of you also know, LMDs were used extensively in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., and we all know how much Kevin Feige avoids other Marvel divisions, especially Jeff Loeb's TV division, like the plague. He doesn't want to do life model decoys, and he has found such a cool replacement. What's more, it's also revealed that Fury post-snap, or again the blip as they're calling it, has set up a base of and we know he snapped because we saw him disintegrate. So anyway, he has set up a base of operations in space! So, oh how the Skrulls have multiplied, they pull back to reveal, because you know, Fury was on a break, you think he's on an island, and they pull back and he's actually in an extensive space station. And who runs the space station? Not, like, who runs the world? Not girls, Skrulls! Skrulls have multiplied and they're all working for Fury. So basically, you've got S.W.O.R.D. S.W.O.R.D. is being introduced into the MCU as the new S.H.I.E.L.D. It was the counterpart to S.H.I.E.L.D. in the comics, but of course S.H.I.E.L.D. is gone, but now I think S.W.O.R.D. has taken its place, which makes sense post-Thanos. And S.W.O.R.D. stands for Sentient World Observation and Response Department, with an army of Mystiques working for it. Wow. Fury can do some real cloak and dagger stuff with S.W.O.R.D. Skrulls. He can do spy work, obviously, with the ability to impersonate anyone, body doubles for VIPs to offer better security, and have fun stuff like high-profile Avengers able to run missions and do publicity at the same time, right? And more. You know what? I'll just tell you now. I saved it for later on in the video. I'm just going to tell you now. For instance, many of us felt that, as was the case in the comics, when people started to first get wind of Secret Invasion, and that kind of was the same situation in Captain Marvel the movie, so someone who you think is someone else is killed, and when, you know, they revert back to their original Skrull form at that time, being like, what's going on here? So some people people felt or hoped that when Black Widow died, she would be revealed, or, you know, sacrificed herself, she'd be revealed to be a Skrull. But what if it's the opposite situation? What if Nick Fury doesn't want anyone to know that Black Widow sacrificed herself and was no longer around, right? And especially because she has no powers, it would be quite easy. Well, I don't want to insult Black Widow by saying it would be easy, although I'm sure some of you would delight in that, but a Skrull could reasonably take on Black Widow's skill set and take her place. ScarJo, you ain't out just yet. Isn't that interesting? Maybe she's a Skrull in her own movie, the upcoming movie. Maybe Nick Fury's like, there's a position and, you know, I'd be honored if you'd take it. There are just so many cool places you could go now. It's a little complex for Feige, but as I said, a more comfortable and bolder Feige. Let's see if he can do it. And down below in the comment section, I would love to hear your ideas of how Fury could use the Skrulls. All right, now in addition to the Skrulls, there are some exciting other characters who could be working at S.W.O.R.D., both who already exist in the MCU and are also from the comics and haven't yet joined the MCU. And I think this signals some of them are coming soon. So first off, obviously, if Talos and Soren are there, odds are so is their now grown-up daughter, right? I'm sure she would want to, you know, she's going to change in size, right? She didn't have a name in the film when she was first introduced, possibly because, as we'd already said, Feige didn't want to reveal that she is Varonk, who is the Skrull queen in Secret Invasion, who runs that whole operation. Because Talos and Soren like working for humans doesn't necessarily mean their daughter does, right? She could fall in with the wrong Skrull crowd. There could be some disgruntled employees at S.W.O.R.D., right? And you know who else then that means is grown up? Obviously, Monica Rambeau, right? Who got real friendly with the Skrulls, particularly Talos and Soren's daughter. There was that great line about never change your eyes, you have really pretty eyes. And many of us feel that could be a way to identify Talos and Soren's daughter going forward. Even when she takes on another form, she'll have the same unique eyes. That's such good stuff. And remember, Monica told Fury she's gonna go to space, right? And the conversation unfolded with Fury saying, first he was reprimanded by Captain Marvel, or maybe it was after. You never know with Captain Marvel. There was a reprimand mixed in there. But Fury said, well, then you'll have to build a spaceship or get all glowy like your aunt, right? Well, it looks like Monica's already built the spaceship, right? And I'm sure she'll get all glowy in a future MCU movie that's probably coming up pretty soon. I would say maybe in only the next Captain Marvel movie, but if S.W.O.R.D.'s gonna be taking place, you know, as the new shield across all the MCU films, I would guess, well, then it could happen in any movie. I hope it happens soon. Such a visually striking character. Now also, just 30 years later, so that means an older Maria Rambeau could also work at S.W.O.R.D. And either Lashana Lynch could reprise her role Hayley Atwell style, or they could recast it. But I think with the focus probably going to be on Monica now, because she again is the one who becomes the superhero based on the comics, the Maria role will likely be small enough to allow Lynch to continue again, just as Hayley Atwell did. And when you have the Rambeaus around, that means Carol Danvers has got to be close by. And in fact, in the comics, one of her recent titles, she ran S.W.O.R.D. herself. I can't see Carol sitting behind a desk. And in fact, it was a problem for her in the comic itself. That was one of the issues in the issues. But also, interestingly, that comic, on a side note, was written by the showrunners of the Agent Carter TV series. And we, of course, just talked about Agent Carter. Hollywood really is a small town. And it was a pretty good comic for a while until it wasn't, and then it eventually was canceled. Captain Marvel's had a hard time in the comics keeping those things, those titles alive. I hope she always starts off really good and then it dies out, but I think so far so good in the movies. Then when it was introduced in the comics, speaking of the comics, S.W.O.R.D. was run by one Abigail Brand. Half alien, half mutant. So, I mean, I don't know if that'll be a way to introduce the mutants, or if maybe she'll just be half alien. But again, in the comics, Brand has the ability to wield an intense fire that can burn through metal and speak alien languages that humans biologically cannot. Her natural green hair is just cool, even if Polaris did it first. Then also, this is where things get really interesting. Abigail Brand is just a fun Easter egg. This is where things start to work in with the storylines. So fan favorite Spider-Woman, aka Jessica Drew, has also been an agent of S.W.O.R.D. And what do you know, Carol Danvers' best friend in the comics. Many people are like, when's Jessica Drew gonna show up? Well, guess what? She was also a key figure in Secret Invasion. She was the one who Varonk impersonated to infiltrate the Avengers. But here was where it could get really interesting if Foggy wants to change things up, narrow down his cast, right? What if Talos and Soren's daughter has the Skrull name Varonk, but maybe she likes to go by the more human name of Jessica? Doesn't that sound great? Jessica Drew could also, though, simply be yet another new character, which would take away the last shred of a chance that Maria Hill has for any genuine screen time. They even look very similar. I'm sure Colby Smulders is like, maybe Maria Hill could just fill the Jessica Drew spot. And you know what? Maybe she could. Although, if I wanted to infiltrate the Avengers, I wouldn't impersonate Maria Hill because she doesn't really have particularly impressive access. Oh, Skrull burn! I'd never impersonate you! Alright, so in the comics, Secret Invasion led to Dark Reign, aka the Reign of Norman Osborn. And all the other villains were working for him, but it was really about Norman Osborn. And of course, as we've been discussing, there are rampant rumors that Kevin Feige is eager to introduce his own Osborn, rumored to be played by David Morrissey, who's going to be showing up in a couple of MCU movies going forward. There was some thought, well, I told you I'm not going to give any spoilers away for Spider-Man Far From Home. We'll discuss that in a separate video. But I still am continuing to hear that Osborn is indeed coming. Because, hey, the world needs a new tech titan and weapons dealer to take Tony Stark's place. A vacancy has been created. And so Secret Invasion and Dark Reign might happen simultaneously in the MCU. Only this time the Skrulls are the good guys? Or maybe they're both, because, you know, it's a group of people, and some of them could be working for Fury, but some could defect to Osborn, right? I'm sure that Fury can't create a situation where you have to work for S.W.O.R.D., so again, things could get real interesting and complicated. Oh, Feige, I hope you know what you're doing. More comfortable and bolder. Woo! This new Feige is exciting. But bottom line, starting now, you're not going to know for sure who you're looking at on screen, right? Because it is time to play our new favorite game or new frustrating game, Who's a Skrull? I don't think anyone else could be a Skrull just yet because, you know, they haven't really shown anything about post-blip except for Spider-Man Far From Home. So the game starts now. And that's where I came up with my Black Widow situation, you know, especially because Talos says, everyone's asking where the Avengers are, man, and I'm running out of excuses. Maybe Fury could just have a dummy set or a Skrull set. So how does this all sound to you? I can't wait to hear your thoughts down below. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. Tons of more Spider-Man Far From Home and MCU content coming. And of course, we have Comic-Con coming up, D23, lots of stuff. And then, as always, there's more videos that you can watch right now.